Welcome to Blush, America's premier glamour magazine. I am, of course, Nina Van Horn. My face appeared on over 40 covers. I was the Noxzema gotcha girl. You know, gotcha. Yeah, well, ask your parents. So, you want to grace the pages of Blush. Well, I want my old ass back, but chances are that's not going to happen. But remember, just the fact that you're here at all is something to be proud of. You'd be amazed at how many girls can't find the building. Okay, this is fun, isn't it? Thank you. No. Yes. Stay. No. 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 Honey, I don't know who your agent is, but you need to grow 6 inches, lose 20 pounds, and find a hairdresser who gave up cocaine with everyone else.
Excuse me, do you own this magazine?
No, that would be Mr. Gallo.
And I would be Mr. Gallo's daughter. Gotcha.
You know, dear, you can understand why I didn't recognize you. I mean, there is virtually no resemblance.
Go away.
Oh, there it is. Oh, Jack, Daniela has cheekbones for days.
Go away.
Oh, and there it is again. Look at her. Writing her first big article for Papa.
So?
So? First it's an article, then it's a job. Before you know it, she's in charge, and I'm back at the boat show wearing that damn mermaid suit. Maya, dear, I understand you're writing this month's relationship column. Can I peek?
You peeked years ago, honey.
So, is this article the first of many?
I doubt it. It's called My Father is a Jackass.
Oh, Maya, he's your dad. Add the word senile. She'll be gone by the end of the day.
Ray, just make it look like an accident.
No, no, she's leaving on her own.
Got it, we never spoke.
Hi, everyone.
Maya, darling. Were you in the neighborhood, or is this take your daughter to work day?
Actually, Nina, I work here now.
Really? In the same building? What fun. We'll have to nod hello to each other in the elevator sometime.
No, here at the magazine.
Oh, you are. You are such a character. Oh, my God, you're not kidding. Finch, did you know about this?
Of course I did. I know everything.
Then why didn't you tell me?
Okay, I didn't know. You got something on your jacket there.
Oh, damn, the baby threw up breakfast.
Well, that makes two of us.
All right, a fresh take, a new perspective.
Wow, a new perspective.
It's about how designer clothing companies exploit foreign workers.
And Maya, you're new to the fashion world, so let me introduce you to the phrase, pooping in your own nest. She's new, she's fresh, she's got ideas. Yeah, well, the writing's on the wall and it says, adios, Nina. Bam! This was the year I was going to open a savings account.
I'm as upset as you are. I just don't have the worry lines to prove it.
One more crack like that, and I'll put the M&Ms on the high shelf.
Which one of these thongs is more sophisticated?
Oh, don't bother me. I'm in crisis.
If this is about Maya squeezing you out, don't worry. It won't be long before Social Security kicks in.
Oh, my God, I can't breathe.
Here you go, baby.
Oh, please, I'm not going to breathe into that. Oh, you know, it's so unfair. I've worked here for 9 years, 3 of them practically sober. Jack, having Maya here is a big mistake. The 3 of us are the backbone of Blush Magazine.
The 3 of you, I only see 2.
Me, Finch, and Elliot, you bastard.
So you're saying I'm wrong to hire my own daughter?
Well, Nina, answer the man. I tried to keep her out, Jack, but her diet pills give her the strength of 10 former models.
Well?
Jack, all I meant was...
Yes?
I... Gotcha! Today is National Say the Opposite of What You Mean Day. Isn't it, Finch?
No.
See? Jack, may I say that although Maya and I only worked side by side for one day, I feel that I can truly call her friend.
Sorry I'm late.
Maya!
You!
And I think Maya'll fit in best as articles editor.
Damn, I knew. Articles editor? As in articles? As in no say over beauty and fashion?
That's right.
Oh, thank God.
Unless the article's about beauty and fashion.
Dear God. Dr. Lowell Fisher, the most prominent plastic surgeon on the Upper East Side, is giving me a free procedure for referring all of these models to him over the years. Because of me, he's raised more asses than the Queen of England. No need for a tummy tuck. Thanks to my smoker's cough, my stomach muscles are ripped.
Pull back your face and hold it. Okay. Now let's see what your lips would look like with collagen. All right, now give me an eyebrow lift. That's perfect. You don't move a muscle, I'll go get my camera.
Okie dokie. Jack, here's the mock-up for that lipstick piece.
You get a building permit for those?
Don't you just love them? They say, here I am.
Pretty gruesome, huh?
Just wish I'd had pie with lunch, because I think I'm going to barf. Hello, all. Guess what today is?
Wear your underwear on the outside day.
Oh, look who had cereal with sugar. Now, today is my birthday.
No, I mean, he's still breathing? How old is that guy?
300 million. Sorry, that's his net worth. I always get them confused.
Men in power have used fashion to subjugate women. Did you know that Louis XIV invented the high heel shoe so that... What are you doing?
I'm miming our readers hanging themselves out of boredom.
To commemorate the 40th anniversary of Jack Kerouac's publication of On the Road, I thought we could trace the impact of the beat movement on modern fashions. What?
Oh, now I'm so bored, I'm electrocuting myself.
Hi, Nina.
Oh, you caught me. I was just about to indulge myself with a little ice cream on my birthday. Oh, so good. Next year, chocolate. Oh, welcome, my dear, dear friends. Though your names elude me, your presence is no less important. You've been so good to me. I said you've been so good to me. You know you make me wanna.
What are you doing?
That's your cue. You know you make me wanna.
Not gonna happen.
Oh, Maya, it's my birthday. Now come on up here and help me sing.
As I mentioned during Ebony and Ivory, I'd really rather not.
Oh, come on. If you sing with me, then tomorrow I'll say yes to all of your silly little story ideas. Hit it. You know you make me wanna
shout.
Throw your hands up and
shout.
Get your legs out of
shout.
A little bit softer now.
Shout.
A little bit softer now. Hey.
Hey, 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 where are you going?
Why would there be anything to talk about?
Because that phone's out of order.
No, it isn't. Look.
I used that phone. You used this phone.
Whoa, no more tequila for you.
Nina, you're still young.
Oh, yeah, maybe for a senator. Wait, now that we're friends, just let me go and erase your name from the men's room wall. God, I'm so hungry I could eat an entire sandwich. Hi, Maya. Good morning.
Don't worry, I told them about the dentist.
What dentist? I was having sex with a man practically half my age. Oh, come on. Now someone has to take a stand. We fur lovers are tired of living in fear. When my friend Vinny's new mink coat was splattered with red paint by one of those anti-fur thugs outside of Rockefeller Center, of course she fainted right on the spot. Seeing her lying there, covered in what looked like blood, her cheeks sunken from an unfortunate facelift. Well, naturally, the paramedics just assumed that she had jumped to her death from the rooftop. Thank God she had her cell phone, or she'd still be in that body bag.
Nina, I'm just gonna assume you didn't read the no smoking rule last night because you were out sleeping around.
Oh, I read read it. I also saw the no pets rule, yet strangely, Jack still has you.
Seriously, no smoking.
Hey, back off. It helps me relax. I was seated across from this fantastic-looking guy. Our eyes met. It was electric. Before I knew it, we were side by side, his fingertips slowly tracing the line of my knee, then gently moving up my outer thigh. Oh, it was so romantic, so sensual, so... Where the hell is my wallet? Oh, my God, he stole my wallet.
What did he look like?
Let's see. Strong chin, hazel eyes, Roman nose, and really salty earlobes. There. Perfect. An article on aging next to an ad for vodka. Problem, solution.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
Okay. What's going on?
I don't know. I haven't felt this way since 1969 to 1978.
All right, maybe we've got the flu.
We had the flu. Could I do this?
Has anybody seen Jack?
In what sense? Sad part is, I could have been an angel. One of Charlie's angels. But you didn't know there were going to be four of them. I was going to be Dara, the angel with expertise in explosives, nunchucks, and ESP. Yeah, but then testing decided that I wasn't likable enough. Yeah, well, you try running around all day with nunchucks strapped to your bikini and see how likable you are.
For the last time, just spell your name.
Something's different. Everything's in sharp focus. I can think clearly. Oh, just in time for happy hour. Maybe I'll meet someone nice.